going to be watching some more infomercials. I have a bunch queued up here. We're not just going to do food this time. The first one seems very, very interesting, and I'm very curious how it plays out. Have I seen Morbius? No, and I'm never going to see Morbius. I'll probably have a dream about the movie Morbius, and that will count as me watching it. I think that... Is that fair? I think that's fair. Morbius is better than your streams, okay? But I have a multi-million dollar, like $100 million Marvel Studios project that had 5,000 people work on. Is better than me watching infomercials? But here's the thing, are you sure? All right, this one's called Amazing Discoveries Infomercial, The Human Calculator. Human Calculator. Apparently it's for a product that teaches you how to do math really fast or something. And I thought, okay, I'm very curious. I need to know.
Coming up next on Amazing Discoveries, we'll show you how to turn on the human calculator in you.
Now, all right, here's the host of Amazing Discoveries, to know this.
Mike Levy.
Welcome.
Holy
welcome.
Shit. That sweater is fucking insane. I love it.
Who is fondly referred to as the human calculator. You'll see why. Scott Flansburgh.
Oh, he's here.
497 times 35. What is that?
17,395.
Whoa, they put him on the spot.
But there's more.
Hold on. They put him on the spot for that. Is this a game show? No, this is not a game show.
Scott, here's a hard one. What's 4,379 divided by 7? What is that?
625.57142.
What? Wow. All right. What the fuck are you talking about?
Now,
what?
Obviously likes math. But let's be honest with ourselves.
Is there a screen?
How many people in today's studio audience have been frustrated or intimidated by math? How many people here?
Me? I don't know shit about math.
But you know, the important thing is that if you don't pick up math young as a child, it can actually slow down or stop how far you can go in life. It can limit how much money you can make.
What the fuck?
And aren't we tired of hearing how America's educational system is falling apart? How other countries like Japan are producing smarter kids? Huh? Well, today's amazing discovery is going to turn all that around because our...
When did this come out? 1980 something? Like 80, like 3, 84? That statement, I remember, if you don't know math, you are gonna be fucked for the rest of your life. If you don't understand how to become a human calculator, you're gonna be eating out of a dumpster tomorrow.
Mike, just keep an open mind because today I'm gonna show you and everyone watching
how well, can we do this?
The power we have deep down inside us and we just don't know how to turn it on.
That would be great. But before you get started, Scott,
if this works, let's do it.
We have one of our famous Amazing Discoveries challenges just for you. Are you ready?
I'm ready, Mike.
Okay.
Oh, this is to prove it.
Scott Flansburgh appeared on Gary Collins' home show. And by the end of the show, 22,000 people phoned in and admitted that they were poor in math. And we've invited four of them to join us here on today's Amazing
Wait,
Discoveries.
What?
And they're from across the nation.
Hold on a minute. He was on a show and they said, hey, if you suck at math, call in. And 22,000 people called in and said, hey, I can't do it. And then they picked four of those 22,000 people. Okay, so I wonder if you're understanding how this played out here. Who cares? That's not a big deal.
And they're from Florida, from California, and even all the way from Alabama. Welcome, everyone.
Yeah, but I mean, this is not fair. This is a kid. Okay, but now, you don't, how would you know all that math if you're like a kid?
By the end of today's show, he's going to have you all doing complex math calculations
okay.
in your head.
I'm here too. I would be number five.
Scott, go for it.
Oh, no, Mike, I'm not going to do it. I've got to do this show with you. So what I did was I brought a friend with me that's going to take him backstage during your show and teach him how to do everything.
Okay, bring out Scott's
what?
Friend.
Kevin, come on out. I need Kevin.
There he is. Wait a minute. This is a
Kevin's fun. A child!
Everyone here want to see some more demonstrations from Scott?
Yeah, okay. Let's see it. I want
to
see how this...
I'm
very curious.
We've enlisted the help of Ray Gayton. Now, Ray Gayton is a certified public accountant from a nationwide accounting firm.
They got like a tax attorney?
And he's here to check Scott's accuracy. He's going to follow along with Scott using his adding machine here. And Scott...
This is an expense they didn't have to have. In this image right now... This man is holding a calculator. This guy and this guy doesn't need to be here. He has an adding machine. What is this? What the fuck is this thing? Is that a fudge brownie? What are you talking about? Why does this guy have to be here?
Patricia, let's give Scott a big long row of three-digit numbers to add up. Give him four three-digit numbers and Scott's going to add them in his head. Go ahead.
333.
Plus?
454.
That's 700.
Plus?
699.
Plus?
13. It's 14.
And okay. I got to give you one, too. Here's
it's
one.
20.
984.
I don't know. This is stupid.
3,469.
Right up.
This is a calculator with paper.
Sure, Mike.
That was a calculator with paper in it.
Cassie, let's give him a hard division problem. How about a four-digit number divided by a single-digit number?
5,973 divided by 7.
853.285.
He's using the force.
Wow, God, how do you do that? How do you...
973.
Hold on a minute.
Divided by
7. Oh, wait.
800.
Right here, this like, the like, I can hear the music.
53.285714.2.
Yeah, right.
God,
that's fucking impossible.
How do you do that in your head?
Mike, it's so easy. If I could you have the girl that gave me the addition problems? I want to bring her down here.
Go down there
and teach her how to do it.
I want someone to get like power bombed through that table.
When we normally
this
add
table.
The numbers up. Problems.
This is the set table that is breakable. Let me just give you some insight here. This is made out of like plywood, like one like small thin sheets of plywood and no supports. This is made for someone to go through this table. But I imagine somebody's going to get annoyed with this guy and they're going to go at it and he's going to get like fucking choke slammed through this table. Yeah, it's like an Eric Andre table. Yeah. This is the I'm going to go through this eventually table.
But I want to show you a real easy way to get the answer, okay? Now, instead of starting over here, let's start on the left-hand side. And this one right here, doesn't it stand for 100?
Yeah.
And what does this 2 stand for?
200.
Okay, so now let's keep a running total in our heads, okay? What's 100 plus 200?
300.
Plus another 100?
It's 400.
400.
Right, plus 200 more?
600.
Okay, now let's go to the top of the next column, which is the tens, right? So this 2 tens stands for 20, so add it to 600, and what do you get?
620.
Plus 20 more.
640.
Plus 20 more.
660.
Plus 10 more.
670.
Okay, now look, go to the top of the ones. What's 670 plus 3?
But this is like a lot to do in your head.
Plus 6 more.
679.
Plus 1.
680.
And 4 more.
684.
684, and that's the right answer.
Patricia!
What? No fucking way!
That gave me the real hard division problem. I want to show you
the division problem. Now this one is horseshit. I'm curious about this is horseshit.
Cassie, are you pretty good at multiplication?
Yeah.
All right, I'm gonna show you a shortcut for real big numbers. Like, let's say we wanted to multiply 95 times 95, okay? Now here's how you do it. How far is 95 from 100?
5.
Okay, so what you do is you put minus 5 underneath, and what do you get? What's 95 minus 5?
90.
You had it, it's all right. And now take this number here and square it. What's 5 times 5?
25.
And right down here, and that's the answer to 95 times 95. 9,025.
Yeah, but this is, all right, well, hold on. But this is not.
You try one. 96.
That's not the problem he did, though. That's not the problem that she said. Wasn't it like a huge amount of fucking decimal points?
Of 109.
Did they get this guy in a time machine? This is this person. Now, let's see if it works on me from fucking 40 years ago. How is the same person?
112. What's that, Zach?
58.
The same voice.
You did. Very good.
Well, those kids.
This is
really
the same person talking.
Us.
All right. Where does this end up? Wait. We got. Hold on. We have an expert.
I hated math. I hated it through high school. I hated it in college. And I was so thankful.
So I fucking sued it.
At law school.
I sued it. Lost.
A litigator.
$40 million.
That was the
side of you. 5 for shipping and handling.
Students drill and kill type activities. Which.
Sharp
mask
skill.
Ready?
Yeah.
Huh? All right, human calculator. That was a pretty good one. That was a pretty good one. This one is the Martinetti's bring home a computer.
The following is a paid advertisement by Apple Computer Inc.
This is a dramatization. All characters are. Why would you say that?
As far as I can tell, families have two kinds of people. The ones who want everything to stay the same, and the ones who want to spice things up a bit. I guess you can count me in the second group. Zoe,
why are you standing
too.
Like that?
She's my sister.
I feel like I stand like that
Frank,
in pictures.
He's always up for something crazy. And Mom, she's a classic. Gramps loves opera, so you can count him in for
I did all this on my computer.
And Schubert, he's just cool.
Schubert?
I guess in our family it was only Pop who was really set in his ways.
Wait.
Of course,
who?
We all thought that was really set. I guess, and Schubert,
Schubert.
He's just cool.
Oh, is it the...
I guess in our family it was only Pop.
Hold on, wait.
And Schubert loves opera.
Oh, it's the
so
dog.
You can count him in for
It's like, is this guy's name Schubert? Like, that's interesting. Why are you calling, dad by his first name?
As for Pop, he's got his own ideas about things.
Where's the sports?
But he's a great guy.
Never
find. Hey, Pop, check this.
That's pretty clever, DJ.
Yeah, Pop's understanding, supportive.
But no points.
Son, delete that. You fucking put that on Facebook either. Making our family look fucking stupid. Making me look like an idiot. Don't put that on Facebook. Is it already, how many likes does it have? 40? Okay. All right, if it gets to 50, I won't be upset.
I hear you can even get music on the computer.
Opera?
Sure, Gramps, and pictures too.
What, you can do that on a computer?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, hey.
The kids could really use...
Nothing has changed, by the way. Nothing. Zero. This was like 20 or 30 years ago. The exact same conversation happens. That, like, wait, what do you mean a computer? What's a computer? It's, I mean, we've 30 years have gone by. That this is this always going to be like this? Like, when I get to be, like, 80, am I going to look at grandkids and stuff and be like, wait a minute, what is a computer? You could do that on a computer? What's a computer do? Like, is the old people always just don't understand? Like, even though I've been using computers, like, my adult life, right? Am I just not going to know?
Well, let's see.
It's EB Games?
You'd be interested in a computer the whole family could use, right?
Right, yeah.
Something with multimedia.
Yeah!
Yeah.
Well, we have a lot of PC clones in stock.
PC clones?
PC?
Ugh! On sale. Of course, you want to add a few options.
Windows?
A CD-ROM drive, need that.
What the fuck? No, get that out of here.
Sound card, need that.
Ugh.
Memory management and adapter.
Oh, what the fuck?
Of course you want to memorize some commands. You'll need some instructional books for that.
Yeah, you need all this shit.
Fletcher was...
You need all this. You need a graphics card, and you need a sound card. You need a monitor and everything, and look at how much that is. Now let's come over to the Apple computer, which is twice as expensive as what I just showed you.
A Macintosh Performa.
Yeah. Huh. Fletcher showed us the Performa. It was like the Macintoshes we had at school, except it came with a whole bunch of extras. It had CD-ROMs that Zoe and I could use for learning. There are programs Mom could use for her home business.
Whoa, look at all these financial charts.
And a modem, too, to get information online. Plus, there were games. This was a lot
Is Grandpa the gamer?
PC with Windows. Games. Mine. Plus.
Grandpa's the gamer.
If the family proves that they really need it, then you gotta pay me back.
Oh, Dad.
So that's how it started.
A little friendly wager. What do you say?
Gramps was gonna buy it and bet Pop that we could change his mind about computers.
You're on.
I'm on?
Okay.
Okay, you got it.
And that's when Pop thought of points.
Okay, kids. Everybody.
Points?
We get 100 points in 1 month, and I'll pay for the computer.
How do we get points?
I'll figure it out.
You.
All I knew was that we were finally
scammed by Grandpa.
No, not you.
And the next month was going to be very interesting.
Grandpa just goes in and grabs him, like, right here. And they go into the back and into the computers.
Okay, what do I do now?
Click here, Mom.
And right from the start...
what do I do now?
Uh-huh.
You imagine being presented...
Okay, what do I do now?
Being presented with this for the first time... Okay, back in, like, the, like, 1800s, if you were to film, like, a train coming towards the camera, the people in the audience would run out of the theater, thinking the train was going to hit them. This is a very, very, this is a very collected response to this kind of, you know, technology. This is the first time you're seeing this. All right, what do I do now? Like, yeah, that's very collected. I would be freaking out.
Now, remember our deal. Earn 100 points. And I pay for the computer.
Dad, the thing's fucking phenomenal. It's a remarkable, new, ridiculous piece of technology. You lost. I mean, come on. Just pay Grandpa. It's like, really?
Otherwise...
How do we get points?
Well, here's what I've worked out. You do your homework on the computer, you get a point. You raise your grade, you get 2 points.
No, 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 no. Come on. That's worth at least 10.
Yeah, Grandpa, come on.
All right.
I have to hand it to Pop.
5 points.
He never makes a decision lightly.
If I use it for business?
Yeah. If you told him this computer could take him to the moon, he'd want to go 3 times.
Well, no. You know, the reason why Grandpa's not into this is because this kid's got, like, fucking D's. And he is now has to rely on this kid to make it so he doesn't have to pay, like, $2,500 for a computer. So it's like, hold on now. Let's not tie it to grades. How about, let's tie it to times that they do the dishes. Is that better? That sounds better. That's a good idea.
Open wide and say, ah.
We played this game. We actually played that exact game. That's Dinosaur Adventure.
Zoe had a whole other universe to explore. She loved learning with multimedia and couldn't get enough.
Arthur's teacher trouble.
She could read stories that came to life.
That week, everyone in Arthur's class studied harder than ever.
And that taught her things about the world.
Bro, what the fuck happened?
Fletcher had said...
We went from this to, like, Elsa beats Spider-Man up with a baseball bat. What the fuck happened?
There's 72 points here.
They're so close.
Not bad.
Of course, Zoe thought she deserved points for beating Pop in games.
No points for games.
And Gramps agreed.
Hey, why not? You learn things from games.
Exactly.
Frank and I Empire thought so. But Pop didn't exactly see
well,
it our way.
Somebody's not learning enough.
TJ, we'll get points if you bring your math grade up.
I know, I'm working on
got a D.
It.
The proof's in the pudding.
That's my grandpa was
no,
so, didn't want to do that.
The proof
I hate it.
Is a in the pudding. I like it.
Okay, everybody. Family picture. Perfect.
Oh, this is where
was, we were having the time of our
lives. Circle. Here we are.
And there was no turning back. We just had to convince Pop to keep it. We were desperate. And desperate people try anything. Even math programs.
Was he eating out of the dog bowl?
People try anything. Even math
what
programs.
What is that?
This is our house.
This is my room. This is our kitchen.
Not the
this
bar,
is my
maybe.
Homework. This is due tomorrow.
This is where I plug in my guitar. This is where you plug in the printer.
This is a lawnmower I'm fixing.
This is a proposal.
I thought he was plugging the lawnmower into the computer. Like, dude, that's not... you got that. You got wrong info, man.
Fixing.
Ties.
Checks.
Paints.
Faxes.
This is my encyclopedia.
Our taxes.
Astronauts. Dinosaurs.
Socks.
It's this always dinosaurs. Our... Have you noticed that?
This is our Mac.
It's easy.
You guys notice that all old... multimedia, all old software, apparently has to be dinosaur related.
I remember one night, I was awake late.
Oh, he's gonna catch Dad!
There was Pop. I couldn't believe it. He was calling up eWorld to get quotes on stocks, and he found news articles he wanted too.
Then that's he what he told me. Why the cat lied to me?
Budgets and investments.
Yeah,
he could
investments.
Even use his DOS files from the office right on the Mac.
And MS-DOS. Stocks.
I know you're there, TJ.
Have you ever used this thing before?
The last few nights.
Are those milk and cookies? Is, what, is Dad Santa?
Can I pop?
Wait, I don't...
And then came the day of reckoning.
With just a couple of more points to go.
You didn't add mine, Dad.
Why, you got points?
What for?
Oh, I use the computer to balance the budget, analyze our finances. I made some big decisions on it. Put me down for 5.
5?
What? Yes. Even Dad is there doing it. And now Dad added points, and the computer
what?
Now is he has to
we
pay
did.
For it.
We did. We did.
What's happening?
Right. We're keeping the computer.
No, I'm in the wrong
I
house.
Love this grandpa.
This is Rose.
Well,
hey, Rose.
TJ.
Welcome.
Zoe. Where'd you two meet?
Right over here on the Opera Lovers Forum.
Oh.
The
Opera Lovers Forum.
So that's what Gramps had been doing all this time.
So this is your performa.
Yep, that's it.
Oh, it's
how
a
many
real
piece of RAM, Carmine.
It's a real piece of shit, Eight. Carmine.
I knew you were a power user.
Yeah. You know what? I read all the magazines.
I do too.
Oh, but can it run Crisis? Mine can.
Bean department. This is the conference room.
These are not the Martinettis. We almost missed the fucking dog post credit scene. Is he pissed? Please, is he pissed on the computer? Okay. That's it.
The program you are watching is a paid advertisement for Rocket Chef, presented by Culinaire.
Don't touch that remote. During the next few minutes, we'll tell you about a $40 million giveaway promotion. You can get a fabulous Rocket Chef for a friend.
What the fuck?
During the next few minutes.
No way. No. There's no fucking way. Oh, stay tuned. We've got buy one, get one free. Stay tuned on a fantastic deal for the Rocket Chef. Stay tuned for the $40 million giveaway. Don't go anywhere. You could be rich soon. What?
We'll tell you about a $40 million giveaway promotion.
What the fuck?
You can get a fabulous Rocket Chef for a friend absolutely free. And for yourself, you'll get the amazing fat-free gourmet.
We can't go anywhere.
A value also free. This cooking.
We're not going anywhere. I need to know about the $40 million giveaway. Dude, this company, I don't think even had $40 million in, like, liquid capital. What are they? I need to know what they're talking about. I have to fucking know. We need to know.
During this one-of-a-kind $40 million giveaway promotion, you can get an extra one of these amazing appliances absolutely free.
And $40 million. Oh, stay tuned to find out how you can get not one, but two Rocket Chefs and $40 million for free. Holy shit.
The recipe guide. Nancy, you know, you could spend hundreds and hundreds of dollars to try and buy appliances that can do what...
This guy's doing TikTok shit. Imagine this guy, but framed with just like this, and it's a TikTok video.
You could spend hundreds and hundreds of dollars to try and buy appliances that can do what the Rocket Chef does, but
like,
I gotta tell you,
he's like doing the animated thing.
Hundreds of dollars, we're not even gonna charge you a single.
That's TikTok right there, especially right here, right here.
Not even gonna charge you a single.
This guy was killing it.
Nancy,
okay, no, fuck that. You put edit her in there holding up a phone like this, holding a phone up facing him, and I'm telling you right now, this is a TikToker. I only did that for like the 10 of you that thought that was funny. And I know, and you and I get it. We get it, you know what I mean? There's tens of thousands of people here, and they're all like, this guy fucking, that joke was terrible. But for like the 50 of you, you know what I mean? Like, you and I, we get it. You know, we get it.
Beginning of time, mankind has been searching for ways to make life easier in the kitchen.
Onion!
From the Stone Age to the Machine Age, our kitchens have become cluttered with expensive kitchen machines that just take up space.
What is going on? Why are they all so fucked up? Why are they so, like, disheveled? Why is everything so dusty, and why are they all so beat up looking? The meth lab.
That just take up space and collect.
It's an illegal meth drug den.
Dust. Well, now the art of cooking blasts off into the space age with Rocket Chef.
So
Rocket Chef is like having a see for yourself.
We're almost halfway through this, and there's no more mention of the free $40 million giveaway. Where's the $40 million?
Look at this. Oh, does that smell delicious? Does that look delicious? Oh. Nancy, look at that.
Oh, wow, the sauce. They always do this, and this is my problem. Ready? Here's my problem with infomercials, and this is a big problem. So they make it, oh, look, it's so easy. Nancy, I've got the sauce. I've got the cheese. I've even got the chicken salad. It's all here in front. You need five of these. You have to grate the cheese, clean the fucking machine, make the sauce in there, clean the machine. They have six of them. There's usually like 6 to 10 of these lined up. Of course, it's going to take you 30 seconds to make a pasta dinner. You've got 10 things on the counter. They should do one where they clean it, and then they do it again.
Isn't it
Yeah, because you have five of them.
Some very eager volunteers and those
all right.
Chefs to put
so here comes the pro chefs.
To the test. Hi, Maria, John, and Nancy. This is so exciting. We have three women who are at the mall, and we're going to challenge them with their rocket chefs against some professional chefs like Freddie Saucedo. What are you going to be making, Freddie?
Today we're going to be making a guacamole.
All right, Captain, okay. You've got your rocket chef. You've got all your ingredients. On the count of three, I want you two to start chopping. One, two, three, go. And here we have...
Anybody else kind of feel like this makes, like, the craft and, like, the amount of time and, like, care and passion that this guy probably, like, puts into his food and, like... Oh, look! Look! Some fucking lady can do it in a machine! It takes her 10 seconds! You're... I feel like that kind of diminishes what this guy does every day. Oh, look, this lady came over and... She's not, like, a professional chef, you idiot.
Chef Aaron Lau, wow, that's some pretty fancy knife work there. Do you use that knife work at the Tokyo Hibachi, Aaron?
Yes, I do.
And why do you think you're going to beat the rocket chef?
Well, I got to say...
He's making coleslaw. What? Hold on a minute. They're making these chefs do stuff that only can be made in the rocket chef. Oh, professional chef, like doing a crazy, like he's spinning a knife around. You're gonna be chopping up like cabbage and making coleslaw. Oh, you're like an executive chef at this restaurant behind us. Just make like guacamole, like real quick. You make coleslaw.
The guacamole, check this out, guys.
And who's is better? Oh, you're not even close.
Let's go ahead and have you taste this, Kathy.
No, you know what? No, you get the fuck out of here. Yeah, get out of here, loser. No, please don't. Okay, I'm gonna be. Let's be really. I gotta be real. If I took cabbage in my hands and I just fucking crushed it like this and squished it with my fucking hands, and a bowl was underneath, and I put mayo in it, just like glug glug, and then I stirred it up. I don't think anybody would be able to tell the difference. That's like this, not much goes into that really at all. I don't know why they're making it seem like this master chef. Oh, it's just one of those days, you know, it's just, look at how much better the rocket chef does it. I could do that with my bare hands. It's like carrots. I could literally just break up like carrots in my hands and cabbage. Jeremy, you promised us $40 million. I didn't do anything. I watched the same commercial you did. Did we just watch this whole infomercial and get 1993 clickbaited?
This has been a paid advertisement for Rocket Chef, presented by Culinaire. The program you are watching is a paid advertisement for Rocket Chef, presented by Culinaire. Don't touch that remote. During the next few minutes, we'll tell you about a $40 million giveaway promotion.
What happened? That's... Okay.
How did you make all this incredible looking food?
That's why it's so much food. Everybody here today, I want to show you something Mimi and I have found that is so revolutionary. It has literally changed the way we think about cooking. Every single dish
that's like
eating was prepared.
50 pounds of food
is raw,
so you get perfectly cooked food.
Oh, it's a grill.
And every time.
And just because it's portable doesn't mean that it's small.
Hey Rob, I see you've got 15 burgers and $5.
Why there's so much food?
$100 grill that's never ever gonna leave.
Wait, freeze. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. There are like 13 people here. There's like 40 people's worth of food already here. They start putting burgers on a grill. There's like 15 patties here already. And this motherfucker over here has... you guys need to communicate with each other. You guys need to communicate. You don't cook food over here. Like, I got this already going, man. There's like three or four people making three or four different parties amounts of food.
You don't remember the Red Devil isn't a grill.
It's a portable outdoor kitchen.
Looks like a grill to me.
They're your friends.
I know.
If all the Red Devil was a barbecue that I could take with me fishing or tailgating, it'd be terrific.
Getting called out.
But believe me, the best is yet to come.
This is the Red Devil Super Skillet.
This is what really makes a Red Devil a complete outdoor kitchen.
It's a grill.
The grilling rack and the radiant heat plate. Pop the super skillet over the high output burner, and now I can
cook
on my kitchen stove outdoors without any pots or pans.
Let me show you what I mean.
No, stop making food.
Mimi, the next time we go tailgating with your folks, I'm having some of my famous three bean Texas.
Right now, like Jack over there is like.
The meat starts to brown. It's just like cooking it in your kitchen. Look how easy that is. All you do now is you add your beans, okay?
Uh-huh.
Then we add our other beans.
Right.
Did I turn this off?
Season on the top.
Did I turn the grill off?
That is delicious. But you know what? I actually thought you were going to say fish and chips.
Well, that's possible, too.
All these people are here. These people don't fucking want to be in a commercial. It's just like they just started to do an advertisement now. Look at the reactions. They're kind of just like... what the fuck are you guys doing,
that
man?
That is delicious, but you know what?
Look at... Like... What's going on over there? This guy's reading a book. He's still over there!
It's the chef.
He's still over there!
I don't know. You tell him, man.
Oh my god. This poor guy. Somebody tell him to stop doing
really
that.
Now, all bacon and sausage need to be cooked on a high heat.
Likes to cook those same old burgers and dogs.
Look at his reaction.
Here's a meal you'd never dream of cooking
he
on a high
heat. He can't believe
grill.
It.
Breakfast. Now, all bacon and sausage need to be cooked on a high heat. So we're going to put them on the middle ring, remember? That's the hot zone. Now, when you find your cooking meat on the super skillet...
Still, he goes back to cooking still? I think he's freezing.
Mm-hmm.
Is he moving?
I'm just going to put that in the hot
guys, he's not moving.
Eggs. I'm going to take my eggs and I'm going to put them in the center. Remember, that's the way fajitas are served.
All these things.
On a sizzling hot plate.
They're going to come back one time and one of these is going to be on fire and he's going to be like putting it out with a fucking bed sheet or something. Like, this guy is still here.
And within a minute or two of having finished your meal, you're done and back to the fun.
Guys, I think my burgers are done. I bet you have it.
Like a burger, Rob?
Man, I can't believe it. The Red Devil cooked those burgers as fast as my big backyard grill.
That's right, Rob. But remember, in the same time you cooked burgers and dogs on your grill, we made on the Red Devil Texas chili, sautéed fish and wine and dill.
Fish and chips, fried chicken, shrimp stir fry.
Also complete meals, beans and franks, Philly cheesesteaks, even a complete breakfast.
Even chicken fajitas and lobster.
What? So he knew. Why... was he acting like he didn't even know they were in his backyard, right? Like, it's like, oh, hey, Rob, we're like cooking over here. You're not going to be able to beat us. And the guy turns around and it's like, he's a fucking ghost.
Thing, turkey with all the trimmings.
Wait, it got recalled? It was people being burned and set on fire? What? The intake tube can warm up to as high as 750 degrees. What the fuck? It would get so hot that sometimes it would collapse. Holy shit!
What have you got cooking there?
Pasta primavera.
Wow.
Wait a second!
Yeah, we're big campers, you know, usually we only get to eat back.
Wait, hold on, guys! What the fuck is happening in this video? What is happening in this video?
Yeah. Pasta primavera.
They're cooking pasta on the grill?
Then after that, we saute the vegetables, we put the pasta in, mix it all together, and then we grill the garlic bread right on top in the skillet. Hmm. Now,
why? That looks fantastic. Explain why you did that and not in a pot. Why did you do this? Why? Explain to me why. No, explain why. Why do it here? Like, seriously, that's what I would do.
Look at this. This looks great. What have you got here?
Well, we've got chicken nuggets and we have grilled cheese sandwiches.
Ah, grilled cheese sandwiches.
Mm, that's my favorite.
Now tell me, Angela,
Now tell me, why? You have a toaster oven that's inside of your RV right now. It's perfectly fine. Why did you do this on the grill? Explain to me why. What do you guys got on here? Somebody said human meat. Oh, they've got, you got, what other weird shit do you guys have underneath there? You got, you're cooking pasta on the grill. You're cooking, what do you got, chicken nuggets? What's in here? Well, let's say it's a human leg. You know, we cook human legs and human arms sometimes. Oh, that's not as weird as the pasta. But still fucked up, by the way. Still incredibly fucked up. I'd be concerned. If I went to a backyard barbecue and there was a full, like, 30-pound turkey on the table, and it was like, I cooked this on the grill, I'd go, I'm not eating that.
Take the top off, and here we go. Little dollop right there. Okay, I'm going to mix it in right there. How's that? Okay,
disgusting.
Now, while we're waiting for this...
That's not even, people are acting like he shit on the couch.
I've got a great one.
He didn't get on the couch and, like, shit on it.
Okay?
Mm-hmm. All right.
Same formula and everything.
It's useful.
And that's all there's to it. And the pet hair is useful. Gone like magic.
All right, another great helpful hint here.
Okay,
you would literally buy anything if there was a wholesome, sweet, middle-aged woman telling you to do it. That's not true. This shit does work, though. It's like a carpet cleaner, guys. The carpet cleaner's the same technology. He's
the big green clean machine.
Like a doctor? Who is this?
I've got to tell you, with what I've seen so far, very, very impressive. Congratulations.
This is just the beginning. This machine is three machines in one. It's a dry vacuum cleaner, it's a wet shop vacuum, and it's a deep cleaning machine. $500 worth of machines. And this machine is as powerful as all those machines.
I mean, they've been using this same exact technology for like 50 years. It works.
A very powerful motor. In fact, I will show you later that it can unclog a drain.
All right, we'll hold them to that, won't we? I want to see that demonstration.
Right now, I'm going to show you just how powerful it is as a dry vacuum. Mary Ellen, if you turn that on, it can handle dirt.
That's not impressive.
Even nuts and bolts.
This is, why are they cheering?
Now, if you'd hand me the bowling ball and attachment you're down
not,
under that counter.
Okay, you're not going to try and suck up the bowling ball through here. Won't fit up the hose.
Oh, no. There's no way that's going to work.
All right. You'll put that attachment on there. You'll see it's clear.
Right.
No strings or wires in there.
Nothing up his sleeve.
Now, John, what I'm going to do is I'm going to lie down on the table. And I'm going to lie facing up on the table. What I want you to do is hold the bowling ball over my face. And I trust the suction. I created this goddamn product. Ooh, be careful.
All right. Show the people that it's no glue on there.
Okay, just...
Now, Mary Ellen, if you'll turn that powerful motor on.
Okay, we're going to put it here.
Yeah.
Now, shake it.
That's how much I trust it.
Yeah. Now, watch your feet. Watch your feet. Oh, that is powerful. Eric, that was incredible. All right, now, we heard you were going to do a demonstration like that, and when we heard that, we decided to devise a little test of our own here. Right now, I'd like to introduce you to someone who's very near and dear to Mary Ellen's heart. This is her husband, Tom, who's standing by outside our studio. Hi,
what?
Tom. Hi, honey.
Mary Ellen, I think you've gone a little bit too far this time.
What is he rigged up to?
Pull the camera back just a little bit. You'll see that Tom is in the hot seat, or maybe the cool seat, because underneath him, can you see that?
Are they going to put it on his head?
Water. Now, as you can see, we've got a big green clean machine set up out there.
They're
and here's what we're going to do.
If we
get the machine on, okay, we've got a situation set up just like Eric's test. We're going to put a bowling ball.
Oh,
any time during the rest of the show that motor fails or burns out under the stress, that ball is going to fall off right onto his
head.
And Tom, you know what's going to happen, don't you, old friend?
You owe me for this one!
I thought they were going to put it on his head and turn it on and suck his head and then put, drop the lever as if he was going to fall into the water. And I thought I was going to keep him up by holding his head. Okay.
I don't think he has anything to worry about, but there's something about the big green clean machine that's better than anything else you've seen so far.
Hold on. I got to get this ready. This is important. Just bear with me for 1 second, please. I'm going to go away for a sec.
Off right onto a switch. And Tom, you know what's going to happen, don't you, old friend?
You owe me for this one!
I don't think he has anything to worry about, but there's something about the... ...anything else we've seen so far, because we have been cleaning our homes the wrong way. Joe, if your hair was dirty, what would you do?
Trick question. I'd wash it.
If your shirt was dirty, what would you do?
What the fuck is this?
Vacuum big green clean machine deep cleans. It injects a warm solution that grabs the deep down dirt.
Is he all right?
And then extracts
Somebody went in to get him.
Here's the situation as we've set it up. We've contacted a number of different carpet cleaning companies, the ones that usually send you these flyers in the mail, and normally they advertise low prices per room.
Uh-huh.
And we've asked them to give us an estimate based on two rooms,
two hallways, and three pieces of living room furniture.
Why is this a prank?
Now, these estimates are going to be based on the same exact job that the big green clean machine can do. Now, they have no idea they're going to be on camera because we've hidden cameras all through the house. There's what they call a lipstick camera. Hi, Mom. That's a very small
camera. Is that really?
You can see it, and we've got microphones all over the house.
That's literally right there.
Here in the dining area, another lipstick camera up there. And our actress, Sharon, who's playing our housewife, will be seated here, hopefully getting the people giving us the estimates in these chairs. We'll be able to hear and see exactly what's going on.
This is fucking weird.
Don't you make yourself comfy?
Now, let me tell you something what to do. First thing for this carpet, what I can do is like I'm going to show you a little demonstration what we do. We have a few kinds of cleaning jobs. Basic cleaning, deep cleaning, preconditioning, and more. It's all up to whatever you can afford. But the prices would be all together from, let's say, all together for around $500, $450. For the furniture and the carpet, $450, and
somebody said it's a ghost camp.
This will be the whole thing together.
You can't even hear.
$351.35 for the furniture, but that's with.
That's with everything.
To catch a cleaner.
And
okay, wait a second. Say that again.
$909.24.
Now say that again. Say that again, but into this like into this microphone that I have in front of you. No, can you say that into the pot of flowers, just real quick?
The big green plane machine.
Wait, the guy's name is John Bissell. It's John Bissell. This is the man himself.
For carpets, upholstery, and
really? Holy shit! Hey! I use a Bissell. Thing works fucking great. Thing actually works great.
Carpet care for me.
Prove it.
The big green clean machine will pre-spot.
I'll be right back. See? Not a liar. Bissell. Works great. It's got technology in it. This is a Bissell. Bissell! Oh, you know the fucking model number I use? I didn't just go to the store, stop. I don't want you to say the model number. You got same day delivery. Oh, please. Hell yeah? Same day delivery, huh? Same day delivery, huh? Oh yeah? Same day delivery, huh? Yeah. That's a fucking $300 cashmere shirt you just ruined with your don't touch my shirt. I thought that was the same guy for a second. I had to take a double take. I thought that was the same person.
Thanks. Now Eric promised he would show me how to unclog a drain. I'm gonna run over here. Eric, how do we?
I was like, it's him again.
Okay. Let's go over and check with Tom to see how he's doing in the dunk tank.
And let's open it up. As you see, we have a full 14-pound turkey inside of here, cooking from all the vortex power.
Holding that ball up. In the interest of science, no, I've just got to do it.
Don't, no, Mary
I've
Ellen.
Got to do it. I do.
No, don't! Oh, Joe, no. I don't know if he made it. Why is everybody acting like he got, like, crushed by, like, a cinder block? I can't. I gotta... This fucking goddamn infomercials, man. I swear to God, why would they freeze on this? Why would you freeze on this? It's so weird. Why? Okay, we're gonna go to this one.
The following is a paid advertisement for the Express Ready Set Go, brought to you by G Personal.
I need to pause this because I want everyone to know. You have heard me say things on this stream over the last probably 4 or 5 years. That came from this commercial. I've seen this probably 1,000 times. I have made weird references to this and never explained it. I just kind of copied her talking. And people might have just been like, what is he talking about? It's from this. It's from this. This 24 minutes has given me like 4 hours worth of stream content. I've said this before. If I saw Kathy Mitchell somewhere, like at like a fan meetup or a convention or something, I would actually be like, oh my fucking God. I don't give a shit about like, oh, what if you met like Brad Pitt? What if you met like, I can't think of another celebrity. Who's another fucking celebrity? Is there any other celebrity I can think of? Brad Pitt. Give me anybody else. Any other name. Harrison Ford. Yeah. No, it doesn't matter. I would be like, oh, hey, what's up, Harrison Ford? Nice to meet you. Don't care. Kathy Mitchell comes up and is like, hey, Kathy Mitchell here. I'd be like, hands are fucking sweating. She's incredible. She's incredible. She's so good in front of camera. She's so good at, like, taking a show, like, running a show, and being, like, the quarterback of the set. I'm not kidding. Seriously. You're not kidding. I'm not kidding.
Kathy, how are you? Great to see you, too. I love my Express 101.
Well, I think you're going to love it even more now, because look what we can do. Big, thick, man-sized sandwiches, beautiful frittatas.
She said it!
Quiches, full size. And look at these pies.
She actually said it.
Even cherry. You couldn't do that before.
You've improved on...
Man-sized.
I'm going to put a little ham.
Ham looks good.
And some cheese. And some tomatoes.
Yep.
And the top.
Ooh.
Now,
I
like to brush it with just a little bit of olive oil, which is very healthy for you.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll pop that right in there.
Hey, this is like a panini.
And that'll
you say?
In just about...
What'd you say?
And we'll pop that...
What did Kathy Mitchell say?
And some tomatoes and the top. Now, I like to brush it with just a little bit of olive oil, which is very healthy for you.
By the way, I trust Kathy Mitchell more than, like, members of Congress. So, I mean, honest to fucking God, are you serious? This wasn't, like, recalled, right? Please, don't ruin it for me. We've seen, like, 4 or 5 girls at this point. Like, 3 of them got recalled. This one's all right, right? Express, like, 101. Express, ready, set, go. Come on. It's a good product, I hope. There's no really awful article about something horrible happening, right? This won awards. This thing won awards? No recalls on this one. Nice.
Now, this is your traditional...
All right, get the olives
pizza.
Off there.
And that dough smells so good. It's so fresh
wait
smelling.
Wait till you taste. Now, this is just... Oh, and can you hear how crisp it is?
I heard the crunch.
Listen to that crunch.
Are you classic Kathy Mitchell line.
I am, but it's going to be really hot.
I'm going to jump in and eat it.
He goes...
So fresh, so crisp, and so gooey on the top.
And
I
believe it or
this.
Not, that's under 200 calories and only about $1.
Hold on. That's under 200 calories. A slice? You mean the little thing he has in his hand? This thing is fucking 200 calories. That whole pizza is like 1,500 calories. I feel with this guy. This guy's great too, by the way. But like, he has to eat this. Like, he has to do that. You can't just like not eat it.
Jump
and if he takes even 1 second where he's not biting this and not enjoying it, it looks bad. Product doesn't look good. This is probably molten lava in his mouth. And that's a champ, right? That is a champ.
So
are you kidding me? Without even, are they flinching?
Jump in and eat it.
And you can tell how fucking burning hot this is right there. It's like, this is like unbearable, but it's like, the show got to go on.
That chicken is going to take about 10 to 12 minutes, depending on how big the pieces are.
Okay. But you guys, don't
right,
say anything
here,
yet.
I've got a full course meal.
And there's our divider.
And a side dish.
Guys, did you not trust Kathy Mitchell? I'm starting to see some like dissent here. Excuse me? You're not going to give her at least a minute to explain what's going on here? You don't trust her? You should trust her. I actually can't believe this. She had a ramen cookbook. I can't trust her. Are you serious? It's probably fantastic.
These are...
Kathy Mitchell would never lead us astray, ever.
...in the middle, because I want you to see. Look at that. That's perfect medium steak. Now, if you like it a little more well done, you could leave it in a little bit longer. And just catch a little... Now, it's going to be hot.
Okay. Oh, no. Be careful. Yeah, but it's worth it.
It's as good as a restaurant steak, is it not?
Kathy,
perfectly
you met the challenge.
Kathy.
Excellent. Excellent steak.
All right, now how about some chicken?
There's
and
the chicken.
Look at that.
Fantastic.
That was medium.
Unfried,
yes, it was.
Fried
unfried
chicken.
Fried chicken. That's cut the fat way down.
That's a good steak.
Guys, Kathy Mitchell.
Bitter, isn't it?
That's
Kathy Mitchell got famous and popular. She became a huge streamer from this. She got really popular. Well, she played a lot of Among Us. But besides that, she was in like the Minecraft stuff for a while. But she is known for doing kind of like out of the box recipes. So she would like, I know people are like, what the, ew, gross, like cereal. No, it's like she's like imitating recipes. She did like recipe imitations, like leftover recipes. She's not making fried chicken. It's like her thing, right? Why is everybody minus twoing me? What? I'm telling you what's going on here. The Among Us joke? Okay.
Beautiful.
Now, okay. Over here, this was the pork. And again, I love the
fact right. I said the words Among Us. I forgot. That's an automatic minus two from everybody.
Have you been holding something back from me, like dessert?
Well, I have some very special desserts. Come on over here and I'll show you. This first one I've got, it's kind of a giant cookie pizza.
I call it a cookie pizza. Bro, this looks like gas station food. So what? What's wrong with gas station? Some gas stations do pretty good shit. He's talking about ban that guy.
Hi, Kathy Mitchell here with my new Ramen Joy cookbook, filled with unbelievable recipes everyone will love. This entire basket cost under $10, and wait till you see what you can make with it.
Check, I trust her.
Out. Ramen shrimp, ramen tacos, even ramen sliders. Watch this. Brown some beef or any other meat with a ramen seasoning pack. Dump in a package of ramen, a good-sized squirt of ketchup, and a can of cola. Yes, cola. For a fantastic barbecue beef pasta better than what they serve at the rib joint at a fraction of the cost. Want more? Form cooked ramen and egg into a fast pizza crust. Then add your favorite toppings for mouth-watering pizza minutes. It's right here on page 84.
I trust her.
Here's my favorite. Just dump some ramen on top of some leftover chicken and veggies. Add a can of soup.
I trust her.
A delicious feast for the whole family, all for less than $3. They're going like this. What the best salad.
Thanks, Kathy. I trust you. It's good. You're the best. Oh, why don't you take another bite? No. Yeah. Yeah, of course I will. That one was so easy to get down. It's probably fine.
Bestseller, you can
relax.
Easily. Grandma's ramen apple pie.
Ramen apple pie?
I love these recipes. I made the
cranberry
crumb.
Call 1-800-383-7662
to get ramen joy on the special. You must call now. It's probably fucking just for fun.
www.byramenjoy.com. So call.
It's just like a fun thing to do with like ramen. Whatever. It's probably fine. It's probably tastes good. I'm telling you right now, I trust Kathy Mitchell, so I don't care. How about the handy peel? I got it already here.
Are you tired of peel, peel, peel?
This is Stir's sub sound, isn't it?
Are you tired of peel, peel, peeling potatoes? Stop! Introducing Handy Peel, the quick and easy way to prepare a meal. Pick a raw potato, hold under the water.
Wasn't this his sub sound?
Peel and scrub all at the same time.
It is. A pile of perfectly or was for a while.
Potatoes. It's that easy. The secret is the Handy Peel's molded rubbing nubs that grip and cleanly peel the skin. Old fashioned peeling is hard and wasteful.
That actually might be all right. They don't work.
With Handy Peel, you can prepare tasty homemade chips in no time.
And all right, so it don't work. It don't work.
These folks in for a surprise. Watch this.
What is
this? I have chocolate. I want another piece. And I'll put it down knowing I shouldn't have any more. But I'll go get more.
It's a good brownie, yeah? Okay, wait, hang on.
What?
Now, do you think there's a product that could help you not eat that brownie anymore? Would that be amazing?
That would be more than amazing. That would be a lifesaver.
It's a good brownie, though. What's wrong?
It's changing the taste.
What?
Do you want to finish the brownie?
No, I really don't want to.
Are you serious?
What does it smell like?
I really don't want it because it's changing the taste.
What does it smell like?
It's all right.
I couldn't even possibly eat this anymore.
Somebody said there's a little piece of dog shit in the container. Oh, that's fucked up. Are you... Toilet Tunes. Is this TOS? Is this TOS? Is this... I'm not gonna be people like pissing, right?
I'll be right back.
Is this TOS?
Ooh, dry skin.
Are you okay in there?
Fine.
That's not what happened. That's not what happened. I was testing to see, make sure it was friendly for Twitch. It was... Okay, fuck this one. I'm out of here. All right, I'm done. I've had enough. I'll see you guys later.